Is it me, or is everything just backwards? Or is it just the mere fact that I currently reside in California, so I'm experiencing the things that you're going to experience, well, soon enough? And I don't want to say not soon enough, because you don't want this. You don't want to walk around, you know, your streets and have to be, well, harassed, which I actually have one of my friends coming on in just a moment. I'm like, hey, bro, can you do a quick 2-minute Zoom call just so you can explain to my friends what it's like in Beverly Hills, what it's like in Marina Del Rey, what it's like walking around, well, California. And it's interesting. On one side of the street, you're like, it looks fine. Well, let's just pan over to the other side. And even if it feels like kind of normal, my friends are actually moto cops over there, Los Angeles. And they say they can't do anything. Their hands are tied. They are just in they're transient. They're not homeless. They're just in transition, like everyone in California. And like what you'll hear from my friend soon enough is the problem with this is they started putting these out, which he'll explain to you in just a moment. And when I say everything is upside down and backwards and turned inside out, it's the year of, well, it was last year, but now it's still this year. I mean, we're just ringing in 2021 like never before, right? And I'd laugh today. This just came through my feed. I'm no longer impressed that Nicolas Cage managed to steal the Declaration of Independence. And it's not just here in California. It's everywhere. Police enter home, arrest family after neighbor snitched on them for violating the mask rule. Police in Scotland entered a home and arrested a family after a neighbor snitched on them because there were too many people inside. I think it's called Christmas. And from West Coast to East Coast, you got crazy sauce happening. Look up Assembly Bill A416. Yes, this is an old bill now turned new bill. And look at this. Like the bill, the congressman, Nick Perry, what are you sure? Saying it does not violate Americans' constitutional rights. So you put people in camps. I know in LA, we got them all over. They just do it on their own. But like, really? Take them out of home and put them in a camp? And then the people are like, yeah, that's about right. And it looks like people aren't just fleeing California with how gross it's becoming. U.S. Census Bureau, Hawaii's population continued to decline. It actually declined by twice as much. So now that everyone that's leaving Hawaii, which permanently doubled in 2020 and probably will be quadrupled in 2021, where are you guys going? I want to know. Is it going from Hawaii to Texas or from Hawaii to Puerto Rico? And how's the property values? Is that probably crazy? They're probably skyrocketing, right? Everyone's leaving. Property values go up. Everyone just scratches their head. And what does the market look like on home building? Well, looks like it went really bad. And now what? What's going on? We're kind of plateauing. Are we swinging this one? We swing trading this one, kids? If you think home building is where you want to be, here's some ETFs you guys may want to look at. You have ITB, XHB, and PKB, but not financial advice. Don't listen to anything that I say. I don't know. You'll lose money. I have no crystal balls. But what I do have is friends that will tell you what it's like. So let me introduce Eric to you. So hey, you guys. So this is my buddy Eric. We've trained for many years. He actually left my area and went down to a very nice area, which basically destroys my area. It's Marina Del Rey. If you haven't been there, it's just gorgeous. He'll show you. And just the experience, I'm like, bro, you just come on for 30 seconds and tell them the story of what it is like what you are experiencing and why you had to leave. So Eric, hit it.
Yeah. So, I mean, this is kind of like, you know, just an aerial view of like the area.
Beautiful. So you had like full beach, like
pretty much like a 30-minute walk down to the beach and a very nice area, you know, really close to the airport and everything. And then now the whole place is just covered with homeless people everywhere. You know, there's tents set up everywhere. It's, you know, it feels really unsafe. You know, I was telling Johnny Bravo over here that, you know, even trying to move out of the place, Actually, I'm not even sure if I told you this story, but when we were moving out, our moving truck was actually attacked by a homeless person. I don't know if I told you that story. No, I didn't hear that. Yeah. So like, there's like a, you know, to get into the place, it's like an enormous roundabout. Mm-hmm. And so there's not really many places that you could park to load if you're going to move. So they have these loading docks, and the loading dock was a homeless person's house pretty much. So he was throwing stuff at the moving van saying, you know, get out. This is my place.
Now tell them about like what, when you were like the before and after, like you moved in, I remember a few years ago, that place was just bumping. It is beautiful. Yeah. I mean, this is where I want to live.
Yeah. And, it's really nice.
And that,
I mean,
and
it's now. Like, you know, it's like the area was almost like a, you know, party area for the most part. Like I remember in the beginning, it was like, you know, it's, which is annoying, but you could hear like a lot of people above us and everyone on our floor as well. There'd be partiers, you know, every place, every spot was filled. And then as we got closer to now, just every spot was vacant. You wouldn't hear people anymore. You know, we would be leaving our building, and as you walked by places, you would just see all the doors slightly cracked open because people were just pretty much abandoning the place. But even more so than that, the owners of the buildings, they abandoned them as well. They had started construction during that time, and pretty much they just abandoned things. You couldn't even get in contact with people in the leasing office anymore. Like I remember when I was like, hey, you guys know I'm leaving, I'm not going to renew. You wouldn't get emails back from anyone. There were just no more responses. They shut down the leasing office. So who knows, maybe I'm still getting charged.
And really quick, let me just pause you. Let me give Eric a plug just for coming on. He helps people lose weight. So if you want to know. And yeah, so we've trained together for a long time. So if you want that link in the description, his channel, I'll go over to his channel. He'll give you something for free, right?
Yeah. It's all free. pretty much 8 weeks of training, 8 weeks of nutrition. Pretty much how to get started if you're not really sure, you know, where to start. You know. New year, everyone wants a new body. They don't really know, you know, where to start.
Now, going back, what's the homeless like now down there from 2 years ago to now? Like you've seen it, and people are like, no, it's tell my audience.
In the beginning, it was like in Marina Del Rey, it wasn't that bad, but because it was so close to the freeway and because it was so close to Venice, which already had a pretty strong homeless problem. All the homeless started to move closer to Marina Del Rey. And now, you know, at one point, people would think that the homeless issue in downtown was bad. But now that is kind of what Marina Del Rey looks like. You know, you would leave and you would see tents everywhere. You know, it even got to a point where, you know, we would normally see homeless people begging as we got closer to the freeway, you know, at the intersection. But it got so bad that they even started moving up into the residential area. So in our building to enter, there's like this enormous roundabout, and they would actually move up to the roundabout. So they were on our property in a sense. And yeah, and it was bad. And right next to our place, there was also a grocery store, Ralph's. And Ralph's had to actually hire or bring in LAPD to be security there because they would be robbed almost every single day by homeless people and stuff. So the whole area just became really bad.
Do you see it? Do you see it getting any better? Like, is this fixable?
Not at all. No, because California, you know, just to give you a little idea, when our moving truck was actually attacked by the homeless guy, first thought, I was like, all right, well, maybe, you know, maybe I'll call 911 and see if they can come in, see if they can just kind of like, you know, remove the guy or whatever. And when I had mentioned that it was a homeless person, the operator almost like scoffed at me, like, we get like thousands of these phone calls every day. Yeah, okay, I'm gonna move you to non-hostile line or something like that. And no one showed up. I was on hold for like 20 minutes. And, you know, so I just ended up hanging up and I was like, all right, we're just gonna have to pretty much move it and deal with this guy.
One of the guys that we train with, he's a LAPD, and he says, yeah, well, you can't really do anything. They're transient. You can't even use the word homeless. They're just in transition right now. Like everyone in California is is in transition.
Sure.
I'm in transition. Right. I'm going to Texas. Right. You're looking at Texas. Yeah, everyone's Texas running. Right, and well, and our governor is just like, let me tax you some more. But go ahead.
Yeah, no, I mean, you know, one of, you know, someone that we know is actually works for the city of Los Angeles. And he was saying that, you know, the homeless problem really became an issue when they started implementing the porta potties in the underpasses. Mm. So California started saying, hey, you know, we have a big homeless problem. But to help them out, let's install porta potties in all the underpasses in all these areas. So they have places to, you know, urinate and defecate and you know, all that stuff. But that only made the problem worse because now these people could get settled in a sense. You know, there wasn't that pressure of, hey, you got to get off the street. Now it was more so, you know, if you want to be on the street, you can, you know, we'll assist you. We'll help you in whatever way you can. Right. Mm-hmm. And so you just kind of drive through Los Angeles and you just have tents on both sides. Just, you know, doesn't matter what area it is. I mean, they even, you know, they even moved all the way up into Beverly Hills area. Mm-hmm. I have a client who just ended up building a house there, and, you know, he was building it prior, back in like 2018, 2019. And, you know, it's like a $12 million mansion in Beverly Hills. And it finally got finished, like mid 2020. And he was saying that, you know, I remember seeing a post on Facebook where he was saying he can't even go out for a walk around his area without being harassed by homeless people and stuff. And that's like, you know, when people think about LA and luxury living, they think Beverly Hills, I got to, you know, move there or something. And even that area is destroyed.
Wow. Crazy. All right, man. Well, thanks.
Yeah.
Thanks for coming on and giving my audience the insight as to what really, like, feet on the ground, this is what's happening, guys. So
yeah, it's a little crazy.
Link in the description if you want some freebies from Eric. Eric, thanks a lot for jumping on. I honestly gave him 3 minutes. He was training a client and I'm like, like, Eric, hey, I need you for a second. All right, man. Well, we'll talk soon.
Awesome. Cool. Thank you.
Uh-huh. But crazy, right? Like, where do we go? Like, we have to move our money. We have to move our homes. Man, I kind of feel like a transient now. And I went through the comments section from yesterday. Remember, I was like, all these people are like, BlockFi. Okay, all right. You guys take a look. I send you guys. You're my investigators. And you go out there. And some of you guys signed up. So cool. Although I sent you the wrong link. So it's going to go to someone else. Someone else is going to make the money. There's no affiliates on me, but that is perfectly okay. But if you got Bitcoin, right? If you hold it, you let them hold it. I know. Don't give up all your keys. Just maybe a little bit. You get 8.6 APY. That's crazy. But that's these are the times that we're in. And again, if you guys have some red flags, please send them my way. And they give you $250, not me. You get the $250 for setting up an account. I don't know the amount or whatnot, but I will leave a link in the description for that one. Take a look at it. I could be wrong. I usually am. But thank you guys for everything. I got to go hit the streets right now. Do some more. See if I can get out there and film some stuff for you. And if you've made it this far, what the heck? Maybe. Think about it. I'm giving you value. That's good. And also, this is it for my Amazon course. That's gone. So get it now. Get that one. That's gone. I have to give you a little warning because Monday that price goes up. Thank you guys for everything that you do. Much love, and I will see you tomorrow.